At the Josep Carreras Research Institute, we have been working to understand how the unique genetic profile of each cancer patient affects the immune system response against cancer cells, as well as how the unique combination of mutations in a tumor can allow it to evade this immune response. This knowledge will be key in personalizing immune-based treatments. Up until now, we have had to approach a problem with data from bulk sequencing technologies. While it was a good starting point, bulk sequencing data hides the extraordinarily complex ecosystem of different cell types that all interact with one another and display a wide diversity of gene expression and epigenetic profiles. In the past, this meant that every time we suspected a genetic variant had an effect on the immune response against tumors that we could not find, we did not know whether it was because we were wrong or because the effect was only impacting a specific cell type that was not abundant enough to detect it in our samples. This uncertainty made it very difficult for us to move forward.
In our lab, we are interested in the characterization of complex tissues at cellular and molecular level. This type of characterization is particularly interesting when cell systems are challenged by natural perturbations, like diseases, for example. In this context, we focus on autoimmune disorders inducing chronic inflammation, in which uncontrolled inflammatory responses occur and cause heterogeneous clinical manifestations. Understanding how inflammation affects cells and tissues will help us to stratify patients with autoimmune disorders and identify new therapeutic targets. It will, of course, require a deep molecular characterization of the immune system to study how it changes and interacts with the host tissue during inflammation. We will need to characterize the cells in terms of identity and function, and also localize them within the tissue to model these diseases. In this view, single-cell RNA sequencing represents a game changer in the biology of complex systems, and it will help us to dissect the composition of tissues and describe cells and their molecular identities. However, localizing cells within the tissue is also fundamental to understand how immune cells infiltrate tissues and how this process correlates with disease progression.
Our immune systems define how well we respond to infections. However, some individuals have exacerbated responses, whereas others have poor responses. In my laboratory at the Josep Carreras Leukemia Research Institute, we investigate the epigenetic and transcriptomic determinants to these immune alterations. When the COVID-19 pandemic started, we became interested in studying how pre-existing immune conditions determine the response to the coronavirus infection. Comparing the detailed phenotypes of the immune cells and their mutual relationship in patients with COVID-19, with and without prior immune pathological conditions, would help us define the potential elements of our immune system that are more relevant for an effective response to the virus. This requires parallel profiling of the full transcriptomes and surface proteins of all immune cells of patients when the infection is active.
Thanks to the 10x Genomics single-cell multi-omic ATAC and gene expression technology, we can now look at both the chromatin accessibility profiles and the gene expression patterns of individual cells in tumor samples. It provides both ATAC-seq and RNA-seq profiles at the same time. This means that we can simultaneously identify different cell types present in a sample and verify whether or not the genetic variants we suspect are changing the chromatin accessibility and the gene expression of nearby genes, allowing us to better understand how the genetic architecture of different cancer types relates to both oncogenic processes and the immune response to cancer cells.
The single-cell RNA sequencing technology offered by 10x Genomics enables us to profile the transcriptome of thousands of cells per experiment. And this is done in an unbiased manner, providing a powerful tool for the identification of cell types and states associated with the inflammatory process. While this high-resolution cellular map will provide us useful information, the single-cell RNA sequencing protocol requires the dissociation of the tissue, by which the spatial coordinates of the cells are not preserved. However, the Visium spatial gene expression protocol is now able to provide both streams of information, allowing us to generate histological molecular maps of these tissues.
Investigating the immune cell crosstalk is another challenge that is relevant for these studies. In this regard, single-cell RNA-seq and CiteSeq provide the tools to address these challenges, as they allow us to obtain the defined phenotypes of the immune cells that compose the immune system of COVID-19 patients and explore the relationship and communication between different cell types using tools like the CellPhoneDB. With these approaches and tools, we can dissect the differences between COVID-19 patients that had prior immune alterations in comparison with patients that had no defined problems in their immune systems.
While we cannot address this problem with 10x genomics, single-cell multi-omic attack, and gene expression, we are now exploring how to integrate 10x genomics multi-omic data with data from the 10x genomics Visium spatial gene expression platform, which generates both RNA-seq profiles at almost cellular resolution and information about the physical location of the different cell types present in the original tissue. We are hopeful that, together, these two technologies will allow us to characterize human tumors at an unprecedented level of detail in terms of both their molecular and cellular properties.
I'm convinced that the combination of these two technologies will not only advance our understanding of human diseases, but will become a powerful tool for the diagnosis and treatment of patients that are affected by autoimmune disorders.
We are convinced that these approaches can help understand the relevance of the immune system fitness to arm different individuals with the necessary weapons to fight the disease.